Thank you very much. The EFF welcomes the arrest of Netanyahu and part of the engagements in the coalition agreements will be the implementation of the resolution of the previous parliament which said Israeli embassy must leave South Africa. So we are still going to emphasize that. Action SA made it very clear that they are the enemy of the EFF. And the Action SA did not have a manifesto. Their manifesto was EFF. Everywhere Herman went was tweeting about EFF. EFF this, EFF that. Look at him now. He didn't concentrate on his organization. He's concentrating on other people's organizations. So we don't care about Action SA. MK, we are relatives. We are together. If they I had to do saying they don't want to work with the ANC, there's no problem. But now we'll work with them. We'll work with the ANC and work with them also. There's no problem. We are not far from each other. We are one thing with MK. So there's absolutely no crisis. I agree if MK doesn't want to work with the ANC national, and then we work with the ANC national. There's nothing stopping us to work with MK in KwaZulu-Natal and also in Gauteng. So Mpumalanga as well. So there's no problem. There's no animosity between MK and the EFF. So that's what you guys, throughout this campaign, you were trying by all means to try and create a division, and we refused to fall into that. Floyd will be a minister of finance if they agree, these people, because he's the most qualified in all respect. None of the people they've put there have got the understanding of that institution better than Floyd. We're putting a best candidate forward. Pandemic treaty, we agree with that. We'll support that. Border, open border, we're supporting foreigners and all of that. Okay, if this issue is the one that has costed elections for the EFF, why didn't this issue give Mashaba votes? It's not true what you are saying. Rena problem ya rena, kikikim MK. MK took our votes, which it borrowed to us in 2019. There's no any other explanation other than that. If this issue was a concerning issue in South Africa, Gayton McKenzie, mabahambe with two seats, mabahambe. Didn't help anyone with anything. You are not going to be made to compromise a principle to please non-existing voters. Our voters understand our message very well. Our open border policy is, we want Africa that is one. But you cannot do that before you develop the other economies of Africa. And you develop the economies of other African continents through making it easy for goods and services to move around the continent and individuals to move around the continent so that we help develop the continent. These people don't want to come here for the sake of coming here. They want jobs, they want greener pastures. We are a big country, we've got a huge capacity. We can develop their countries and benefit out of that in a huge way. And it's not something that you get elected today Tomorrow you'll be carrying gates around you in a bike. We've removed these gates. Come, come. No, 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 no. Doesn't work like that. You guys are just vulgarizing the whole point. People, 40-something thousand people, I mean 41% of those voters voted for the ANC, which is the one that brought these people here. These people are here already, undocumented. They were brought by the ANC. Why are 41% voting for the ANC still? Because if you hate these foreigners so much, you must hate even a party that has made it possible for these foreigners to enter South Africa. Who has benefited from these xenophobic attacks in these elections? No one. Operation Dodola was contesting elections. They are not going to get anything. Back to the village where they come from. Don't have time. Obet, I would vote to just South Africa. Obet. So we are refusing. We are refusing to switch off oxygen machines. And if you comrades are saying that thing is the one that is costing us vote, I'll let it continue costing us vote. We are refusing to switch off machines. We are refusing to deny children, African children, to study in our schools because they were told they are from a certain country. But they are Africans. Our interest is to educate Africans. We cannot allow that. If this issue is going to make us remain, the five of us, six of us, so be it. We're not going to retreat on a lie, on a scaremongering. The issue when we started in 2014 and 2019, it was land. They were saying, yeah, EFF is going to take your land. They even did a program to give people a title deeds. We're giving you title deeds. EFF doesn't want you to have title deeds. Now they realize the issue of the land is not working. They go find something there, which is non-existent. It's a lie. If you doubt me, go and talk to Mashaba. He will tell you how big a lie is this thing of being xenophobic. And then you think you are going to get votes. No. We don't want votes of tribalists, by the way. We don't want votes of racists. We don't want votes of people who thrive on the division of the working class. We don't want regionalistic politics. That's why we are national in character. And we reject regionalistic politics. We reject tribalism. Because tribalism is equal to racism. Once we start engaging in tribalistic politics as a country, you must be rest assured. We're inviting a disaster in this country. Because the worst thing with tribalism is that it will lead to a situation where people fight in the same country. It will lead to a civil war. Tribalism goes straight to civil war. That's why we don't subscribe to those things. Someone was saying, why are the Limpopo people not voting for Malema in Limpopo? The Limpopo people are voting for the EFF. I don't want to be voted by the people of Limpopo on the basis of me coming from Limpopo. I don't want that. The EFF is not from Limpopo. It's Julius Malema's from Limpopo, not EFF. So don't want to locate our organization into some province. We are a national organization. That's why we fight battles in every corner of South Africa, and we are going to continue doing that. Whether we are in government or not, we are going to fight for our people. We are not going to behave here like people who are riding on a high horse and then abandon the character of fighting for our people. We will continue to fight for our people. And what gives us courage is the young vote from the universities. It means we are growing with a generation. The old will die, the new will emerge. So, I used to say Ramaphosa is a big problem and all of that. Now, that issue is not my problem. It's not my problem. Or Ramaphosa, okay, president, or I say president, that's not my president. It's the president of those things. So, don't involve me in the... We are going to bring our list. People are going to bring their list. And then we put together. Yes. So, if we didn't want Ramaphosa, why didn't you vote him out and stop asking us to do things that you didn't do? You had an opportunity to vote Ramaphosa out. You didn't do it. You know Malema will do it. Do it yourself. The ANC has got all the right to remove Ramaphosa if they want. We are not getting involved there. We don't want. Ramaphosa is not our preferred cup of tea. It's not our preferred. But he can't be a deal breaker. We don't prefer him. We know that he was a collaborator. We know that he's got billions, but he doesn't produce anything. He's not in manufacturing. He's not in agriculture. How do you become a billionaire like that? You do that by selling out your own people. So we can say a lot about Ramaphosa, but he's not an EFF president. So we choose EFF leaders. Even who's going to parliament, to cabinet, it will be us who choose from the EFF side, and then they will choose from their side. They can bring a person you hate so much. You have not won elections, win elections and appoint the people you love. So there's nothing you can do. We are here. That's where we are. So, you know, the good thing with the EFF is that we speak to everyone, including those small boys of the DA, with their grandmother, Helen. We can talk to all of them. Those racists, we have no problem. But we talk to them out of principle. We are not going to find each other. Shame. We are not going to find each other. We just talk because we are talking. But there's nothing we're going to really find from those people. How do you have an opposition declaring an opposition, and then leaving the ruling party to concentrate on the opposition? And all of them, they get formed and then they concentrate on the opposition. Even the new ones. You can see they are bought by Oppenheimer to go and chase the EFF. They wanted to finish this EFF in these elections. The Oppenheimers took millions and millions of money. Hey, we don't want this kind of an arrangement. This EFF is a big problem. They went out to finish the EFF. Look at us now. Oppenheimer. We are here. We are a problem for another 5 years. They have to deal with that. They have to deal with that. Let that parliament must know. The new speaker, don't be a crook. If you become a crook, you will find us ready for you. So, we are in a very good mood, looking forward to go to Cape Town. We must go clean up our boots and our overalls. Sangen, Pesguam. Lessons from coalitions. The only thing you must do in a coalition is to be humble and not don't lie. The ANC lies a lot. That's their problem, and that's what is going to be part of the discussions with them. They lie a lot. They say this and then say something else. Say this and say something else. There is a mayor there, Eni Gurulen, who went to take the powers of the MMC of finance, because MMC of finance is our MMC. He must return those powers. Very emergency election, he defeated now. He must return those powers. Otherwise, we are putting a motion of no confidence against him. Of the ANC. He must return the powers We agreed when we were talking that there's no one who's going to move alone without engaging other partners. He goes to give a speech, and then he announces he removes certain powers from the MMC of Finance. He must know elections are over. We are now on him. And that is going to be part of what we are going to discuss with his leadership. Vulamlom. What is Vulamlom? Return the powers. To show sign of being honorable. Return the powers of the MMC. So that is Vulamlom. So learn to be humble. Learn to know you have not won elections. And then always navigate through. Take each other into confidence. Do not seek to outshine others and convert them as if they are just your puppets and voting kettles, like they're trying to do in Johannesburg municipality. We're not going to allow that. Elections are over now. We're going to govern where we're governing. We're going to govern properly. And we're not going to allow the ANC corruption. One of the positions we're going to demand from the ANC is a speaker. The Speaker of Parliament. Because we can't go into a coalition with the ANC and not have a speaker. The ANC is running the executive. We have to run by the speaker, so we monitor them and we make them accountable. So the Speaker of Parliament might be sitting in front. So we really want to thank everybody. Thank you, media. Those who covered us positively, those who covered us negatively, we understand. It's brown envelopes, they work like that. They make you say the things that you don't believe in. We defeated News 24 as well, because it was in a cahoots with our enemies. And then we defeated Daily Maverick, and we defeated Oppenheimer, Rupert, the Minnell family. We defeated ENCA. When MK was overtaking, the first overtaking of MK by the leaderboard there, I was in a house where they were watching ENCA. Yes, sir. Those ENCA people were celebrating like the EFF has lost elections. So you can see that these people, they don't love us. They do everything in their power to get rid of us. We are not going anywhere. It's corner. And we are in all legislatures, by the way. Comfortably. All the better. We don't para too much. We are in this thing for a very long time. Ours is a generational mission. Ours is a generational mission. There is no one on this table who is 60 years old on this table. So we are here for many years to come. If President Zuma can do it at 82, just not even 50 on this table. So if President Zuma can do it at 82, it means you are going to wait for me until I turn 82. Because I will be here. If President Zuma can hold it until then, CD. I'm not going anywhere. I'm with you. Thank you very much, colleagues. Thank you.
Thank you very much, members of the media. That's it for today. Aluta continua. Thanks, comrades.